Hey, everybody, this is Larry. This is Biweekly Contest 550. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, join me on Discord. Let me know what you think about today's contest, today's problems, however you like. Each problem will have their own video doing explanations and stuff like that, so let me know what you think. Yeah, I'm excited. Recently, I've been really sloppy. I've been saying that for a couple of weeks now, a couple of months now, maybe. I've been just really on a bad streak. Like, I'm able to solve the problems, but my implementation is a little bit bad. Maybe I just need more practice, more deliberate practice. But for now, I'm just having fun, so maybe the rankings don't matter that much because I'm still able to solve the problems. But I've been going to try to slow down, do more testing, and focus on getting it correct the first time and not rush through it. But yeah, let's go. 2, 1, go, go, go. Come on. Oh my. Thank you. So it's prefix and serve. Did forgetting it recently. S of I is less than that. Okay. So this is B and A? Or just A? Say what? This is impossible to understand. Okay. The examples don't make it really that much better. J, okay, so largest index I, so that's B. Is one index, two index, no, that's A then, such that 2 is less than B. Okay, so that's A, J is such that, I mean, J has to be 2 at this point, but swap I minus 1 and J. Okay. Reverse that string. Don't know. I know this one's impossible to read, let alone solve. Okay. Somewhere here. I is 3. And then, okay, so the biggest number, that's 4, so that's 4. Okay, let me swap out A and B, and then reverse the string started at 3. Is this some sort of weird insertion sort? So what is this doing? It takes the first instance of an inversion, in this case, well, the latest inversion, so it'll be OD, it swaps. To be strict. Largest index J. This is me. All the numbers are okay. So then it's the first instance where swap I minus 1 and J. I never know how to do this. This is wrong. Can't even write trivial code correctly. Seems fair. Why? I can't even get this code right. BIC, so then now B and I should be Z, I should be 1. Why is it not 1? Oh, I see. Okay. So far, I mean, we don't expect this one to be right, but that's fine. See. Okay, so now we have to correct code. Just gonna be taking way too long. Yep, 63, 5263. Okay, so then now we can see what Leetcode is doing to Leetcode and see if we could skip steps. Okay. People solved it yet? Two people solved it. Let's see. I mean, this is some like weird bubble up sort. How many people got in this? very smart people have gotten it. We got a pattern. So this is sorted. So now that the suffix is sorted, what happens? It goes to the next one, which is 19. Let me even just look at the third example, 63. This may be a hint, actually. 2 to the fifth times 2. All right, let's look at that one first, actually. So the last two, okay. And then and what happens when you have a new number? So everything after that should be sorted. So now we look at B and we have to try to figure out. Of these two. Now we factor in the B. The number of inversion isn't just n square, because this is already bigger than n square. I'll look at it from the back, but I don't know that I can get anything from that. A weird insertion sort. What does this do? What does the reverse do? I'm trying. What does adding the T? So So this looks at the next suffix, just these three. Can't find any property with this that I can figure out. This suffix is done. What happens when you see a new letter? New letter, it takes DAB, swap the B and the so then now that means that this will be sorted but reverse. And then the reverse sorted, we're trying to get it back to the front, and it ticks. I don't know. But then now this is sorted. C looks at CCD, so then it needs to do the prefix of so then it does BAC. And then it just does stuff until this is sorted again. Which is 24 moves away. 4 factorial is 24. And then it does it for and then B, and then now we know that it can do that. Move to A to the front. So then now you have these things, which is 4 factorial again. Which means that this is 24. Is that right? I guess that's right. So it takes n factorial to sort the thing. And then now we can bubble sort maybe. So now we take the p. Okay, I mean, I have some intuition, but now I struggle a little bit. And now A and then D has to go to the next character. I think I get the idea, but I don't know what the answer of this is, of course. But so now we find O and D, and then now we sort these. Which is already done, so we move this to Y. And then we move this to a D. C is good. Wonder if this actually runs. Okay. So it's good that we have this a little bit. I'm close. Closer. Now I have to figure out how to get it. Oh. And I have to figure out how to handle dupes. So moving this to a Y would require gonna stick the suffix. Looks good. Add a D. It's sorted, so that's still good. Add the O, it is not sorted, so then it ticks. Four moves. Is that right? Because the first move is moving the Y and then moving the D. So it's 2 factorial times 2 factorial. And then now we have to sort it. C is sorted, so that's okay. And then the T will go from the O, which is... In theory, this should be 4 factorial. And we go from 4 to 28. And now we move it to the Y. To plus 24, yep. Okay, let's see. I have an hour. How many people have gotten it so far? People are really smart and fast, it seems like. I need inverse math for this, maybe. Okay, I have to figure out one more. Oops. Yeah, that's what I expected. Roughly, it's 4 factorial over 3 factorial. Always forget how to do modular inverse. Mm-hmm. Really? Oh. Okay, that looks roughly right. Forget this by accident. So we assume everything after this is sorted. Then now we take the count. No, that's not right. What I want to do is, okay. To look at the next one, so 4x in. That's not good. That's not right. That's why I put in the math as well. This should be this should be how do I do the math? And now we're swapping with X, and then we won actually. Half right, that's well. Good start though, but. What is the answer here? So I'm probably off by a little bit of a constant. Let's try something dumber. Should be able to solve this given that we have a lot of time, but still tricky. I need to do this locally so that doesn't give me this stuff, but okay. Why does that the case? I think so. My math is that it is fewer. That's too hard to print out. Something about the uniqueness, that's why I'm a little bit, I was wrong. Why is this particularly? Maybe I just need to suck it up and figure it out. Does this work? Okay, so it is definitely something with the duplicate letter handling that I'm not handling well. I'm trying to reduce the case a little bit. That's good, maybe. That's a very good booking case. Okay, so with the Coco. Oh, it's good. So C is good. C. So the first thing we're going to do is actually T and C. So now it's trying to figure out how to do this. T going to O is well, it's 3. It's 4 factor. Well, it's 4 maybe. But I think I thought it is 6. So that's not right. It's T going from. So just to get an O. O is here. So we have TCCO to sort out. Oh no, okay. No, this is an O. Okay, I'm looking at the wrong thing. This is an O, so we need to sort this thing, which in my math should be 4 factorial over 2 factorial. So that's 12. And here we go, 13. Right? And then here, 13, it goes. So C, we're trying to sort this out. So that's going to be, again, 4 factorial over 2 factorial, which is 12, so 25. Okay. So far, so good. And now this is an O. So to sort this thing out, it's going to be 5 factor. So that's 30, so 55. I mean, I think my math is right, so my implementation is a little bit off. Okay. Well, that's awkward. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, that's right. 18 is after it does all this, which is definitely not right. So, okay, so, dun, dun, dun. This first 4 is fine. Yeah, and then now this is. Yeah, that looks like that would make sense. So now does this thing a C, it goes to one, gets what the hey. So it should be 20. That seems right. So now see that's right. So plus 12. Bad math on the whatever side. I mean, this is right. It does have the 12, and then it goes another 12, another 6. Oh, this is another 12, but oh, I am dumb. Okay. And this is a bad time for my computer to be running slowly, but so close. Okay. Oops. Oh, come on. Of course, now is the time that it is choosing to be slow. My computer gonna cost me some points or whatever. Oh, there we go. My Chrome always fixed the worst time to be whatever. Why is it pending? Oh, come on. Come on, old computer. Oh, because it's printing a lot. Okay, that looks like the right answer. Let's run it again. Now without the printing code. Okay, it still has some printing code. Please. Cool. Whew, that was tough. I mean, I don't know how other people did it. People are very smart in doing these maths, but I was clearly not. I was very fast on the first three, though. So I think. That was a tough Q4. Let's see. I'm not gonna make top 50, but top a little bit under top 50. I guess that's okay. could I have been faster? I don't know. Maybe I could have been 5 minutes faster. I mean, I spent like 10 minutes debugging that one mistake, I think. So I probably could have been 46 minutes. That would have been a lot higher, actually, because I spent a lot of time on that one silly mistake. I spent so much time. Dang it. I knew, I mean, yeah, I mean, I just didn't think about it until I debug it, and I was like, why is this doing first thing? That was a tough one, though. But I spent too long debugging this again. But yeah, overall, I mean, I was way fast on the first Q3. I was hoping that I had a good score, but sometimes it is what it is. It was a hard Q4, but so I don't know. Yeah, I mean, 56, can't really complain. I'm glad that I'm actually, like, I was just also say a moral victory is me not having any wrong answers. So it's the first time I have no wrong answers in a while, so that's good. Q4, I don't know, it's just a tricky one, kind of, but yeah. Alright, that's all I have. I'm gonna go record the explanation, so check me out there. Hit the like button, the subscribe button, join me on Discord, let me know what you think. Have a good week. If you're doing a later contest, you have good luck on those contests as well. I'll talk to y'all later. To good health, to good mental health. See ya.